David Terrell, formerly of the Bears. Welcome to Tattoo You. The real story is like back in 19, my freshman year of high school, man. The real story is, what's up, D-Way? You see I'm representing, man, always. But kids don't do this at home. I got my first tattoo by a junkie. It was like I skipped school. I had like 20 bucks. I was like, my homeboy had his name on his arm. And then my other friend who played football with me had his name on his arm. So I was like, shucks, I want a $10 tattoo. That's the only thing I can afford is a $10 one. I couldn't get no initials, no DDT, that was 20. I couldn't get my name, four letters, that was 20. I could only get something that was 10. He said, what you like to do? I said, I love playing basketball. I love playing football. So he said, let me give you a football and a basketball. It was this right here, man. I was in high school, and you probably can't see it, but Lloyd Carr and Cato June, all those guys, Ian Gold, they was calling my, you know, first tattoo, like the teardrop, Let It Rain on Me. In this song, a girl, Mary J. Blige, first CD, Rain. You know, they took a picture of my arm and put it on the CD cover. It was a football and a basketball, kind of like infused together, almost. And you can see it, and it was like, boom, the top of the football, bottom, bam. And then you just had the Nets, and then you just had the world. But for me, little puny old kid, little arms, and just 1994, I got just that on my arm. And it looked like one of the crappiest tattoos ever on the history of tattoos. And my freshman year, I'm out there, you can get my freshman year at Michigan. Like, I don't have none of this. I just got this on my shoulder pads, and they came and they put me up on the screen with my tattoo, and the whole building was just dying laughing. I immediately had to go get it covered. And so I got this covered, which is Welcome to My World. It looked like a man crushing the world. I hid it for a little bit until my sister told on me. You know, because I was in the house and I was, you know, shirts on, and I got out the shower one day and she was like, what's that on your arm? I was like, oh, it's nothing. And try to get by. She said, no, that's something. My mom was at work. It was just, I begged not to say nothing. Then my mom come in, wake me up that night, like, you went out and got a tattoo? Let me see what's on your arm. And, what is that mess? You don't want to ditch, you don't ruin yourself. You could get a disease. Who did that? I get my one on my leg with me and Jamal Crawford. So we immediately go to the tattoo parlor. He's like, all right, now you got the big one on your arm. Let's go get another one. Where we gonna get it at? Let's get one on our leg. Then my next one was here and here. This is my good side, this is my bad side. And my son's name, and that was it. That's where I'm from, just living in Virginia, Richmond, Virginia, growing up on the north side in an area called Jackson Ward. It was pretty tough, but you know, it's my neighborhood, it's where I grew up at. And then the family is just like the family. It's like all my family, my friends, we all got the family. I think I got the highlight ink now so I can get the glow in the dark. I may be married, and then, you know, ladies, you know, I may be married, so any girls who want to get their name on my rib, mouthpiece on my face. I would do it too. A couple million. I was 18, 19, and I got it, and you know, it was one of the proudest moments of my life because I was a father. I was entering fatherhood, but at the same time, it was scary too, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you about nothing. And now looking back, you know, I'm doing a good job. He lived with me. And every time I look at it, it's just constant reminder that I gotta be a better man every day.